Linda Laubenstein was born in Boston in 1947 and grew up in Barrington, Rhode Island. She had a very different obstacle to overcome than any of our other celebrated women. At the age of 5, she contracted a serious case of polio and was in an iron lung for 3 months. She survived, but was a paraplegic and spent the rest of her life in a wheelchair. But Linda was a fighter. She attended Barnard College, majoring in science, and graduated in 1969 at the top of her class. She then went to NYU School of Medicine, specializing in hematology and oncology, graduating in 1973. She worked as a clinical professor before opening her own clinic to focus on AIDS. She treated many young gay men without hesitation, when they were often shunned by others, and co-authored the first paper connecting Kaposi-sarcoma, a skin cancer, to AIDS. She went on to become an activist in the AIDS fight and established the Kaposi-sarcoma Research Fund in 1983. The New York State Department of Health created an award recognizing her work, the Linda Laubenstein HIV Clinical Excellence Award. Larry Kramer wrote The Normal Heart in 1984 and created the role of Dr. Emma Bruckner, based on Laubenstein, who had treated his partner. Kramer said he wanted to enshrine her legacy forever. He also wrote of her, "Dr. Linda Laubenstein was a great, great person, a supremely gifted physician who was devoted to her patients, all of whom adored her. At one point, she was taking care of more AIDS patients than any other doctor in the entire world, which took a great toll on her health, but did not stop her for a second. She invented or developed the original combination of chemotherapies that are still used to this day. She was beyond brilliant and beyond courageous. I have never known anyone like her, and I hope that my play does her the honor she deserves." Here is a brief excerpt from The Normal Heart, the impassioned words of Emma Bruckner. "How can you not fund my research or invite me to participate in yours? While something is being passed around that causes death. Women have been discovered to have it in Africa, where it is clearly transmitted heterosexually. It is only a question of time. We could all be dead before you do anything. You want my data? You want my ideas? You want my patients? Take them. Take them. Just do something with them." Sadly, Linda Laubenstein died at the age of 45 at her parents' home. She had suffered for years from the effects of polio, the pandemic which afflicted so many lives until a vaccine was discovered. She was brave and brilliant in the face of extreme adversity.